Well, today is Natalie's birthday, and she celebrated by eating 13 cupcakes. Unbelievable.
13?
Yeah, baker's dozen.
Feeling like kind of sick now, just a little bit.
You got good news for us tonight.
I know, we're tracking rain chances,
yeah,
so this is really good news. It looks like decent rain chances, too, not just that 20%.
Yeah.
So we'll get to that in just a minute. We have to get through tonight first. We're looking at very mild conditions out right now. Clear skies, 71 degrees here in Austin. By the way, that's a live look downtown from our Paramount Theater WeatherNet site. Early tomorrow morning, though, we'll see those clouds roll right back in. You know how humid it is. You can feel it when you step outside. A little patchy drizzle also not out of the question early tomorrow. Temperature-wise, we'll drop into the upper 60s. By noon, temperatures right back into the mid-70s. Another very warm day in store for tomorrow. We're finally starting to see some of this cloud cover work its way in from the west. It's taking its time today, that's for sure. But we're going to see this thicken up as we go through the overnight hours tonight. And it's all ahead of our next system. It's an area of low pressure just off Southern California. It's going to track into Texas Tuesday. The pattern has slowed down a little bit, so we're pushing those rain chances back into your Tuesday now. But the track of this upper-level low is really what's going to cause that wet weather. So by early Tuesday morning, we're looking at that low moving into West Texas. And by Tuesday evening, it's going to be up over Northeast Texas. And as it makes its way right across Central Texas here, that's when we're going to see our good rain chances, especially Monday night into early Tuesday morning. It's also going to bring with it a chance for a few strong storms, mainly to our south and west. This is just over our southwest counties, Gillespie, Blanco, Mason, Llano, you're all included in this. A slight risk for a few strong storms, hail, high winds possible, mainly in the Monday night to Tuesday morning time frame. Something we're going to be watching very closely once this rain event gets going. Let's go hour by hour through our forecast now, though. Tonight, we're just going to see those clouds increasing. Some of the green you see showing up there, some of that spotty drizzle that we could see early tomorrow morning. But through the afternoon hours tomorrow, rain chances are going to stay pretty slim, only about 20%. It's overnight when those chances really start to increase. So we'll go 60% chance for rain into your Tuesday morning. More widespread of an event. And it's also possible you could run into some locally heavy downpours with this too. And as far as rainfall totals, well, we're going to keep those anywhere between about a half inch to an inch for most of us. If you hit one of those heavier downpours, you could see up to 2 inches by the time this whole system wraps up and moves out Tuesday evening. All right, right now, here's what we're dealing with. Clear skies, 72 at Camp Mabry, 71 out of the airport. Winds generally out of the south, a bit breezy out of the airport, 14 miles an hour. We'll see them between 5 and 10 tomorrow afternoon. Current temperatures in the hill country, upper 50s in places like Fredericksburg, 61 in Llano. Warmer everywhere else, though. We're all in the low 70s through our eastern counties. And tonight, you notice temperatures are not going to fall all that far. We'll drop mainly into the mid and upper 60s. Tomorrow, temperatures will top out in the low 80s. Another very warm day. 68 tonight. We'll go 81, your afternoon high tomorrow. And that chance for rain, then there you see it. Tuesday, for the most part, especially in the morning hours. After that, we get a kind of a reinforcing shot of cooler air moving in. By Wednesday and Thursday, that will drop those temperatures overnight back into the 40s.